Hello, good afternoon, Professor. Good to see you.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Thank you very
Good
much for
afternoon.
your willingness to go with us to California. I'm Radosław Koszewski from Queen Hedvig Academy. Together with me, there is Piotr Kamiński, who is the president of Queen Hedvig Scholarship Foundation, and Marzena Bielecka, who is a very experienced and very well-known investor in Poland. President of very important companies in the past and now investing the money. If I may propose, would you like to give us a 5-minute presentation about you according to those points that we sent to you in the mail? Then there is up to 3 minutes for each of us for Q&A and 1 minute feedback at the end. Is it clear, or do you have any question?
No, it's perfectly all right. Well, I hope I'm audible well enough. It's a pleasure to be here. And well, I must admit I'm honored. To be honest, before I got the 5 points, I had some other ideas, but I'll try to stick to that, as I guess it's even more relevant to the situation we are here today. And I must admit, being here as the first one, I have no chance to look at anyone else ahead of me. So no comparison, or I cannot learn from the others yet. Anyway, I've been teaching in Staszic for 28 years, so it's a pretty long time, and it's great experience so far, but throughout those years, actually every year I take part in various student trips, and that's where I gain most of my experience in it. So we organize various kind of events, whether they are regular workshops organized both in Poland. Before pandemic, we also organized the trips to Lithuania. And so every year I attended such events, usually as a form tutor or assisting a form tutor in there. But the things I'd like to concentrate more on are the events I, not the events, but participation in it, in which I organized myself, as I was privileged and in that way that I could take part along with the students in such event as Erasmian European Youth Parliament. That was a pretty clever event. We went in 1 year, we went to Rotterdam, the other year to Turin in Italy, and then in Antwerp, where the students actually representing their home city had a chance to meet other students from other bigger cities, well, from everywhere in Europe, and discuss everyday problems of living and thinking what can be made better. My part in it was actually to arrange it all from the beginning to the end. So not only to assist the students during the trip, but first to prepare them, to pick them, then to make travel arrangements, and obviously accompany them and, well, see to any kind of issues, problems that might have occurred. At the same time, I had a chance to meet teachers from, well, other countries also participating in the event. Apart from that, well, there was a kind of tradition since I attended, I believe, 10 or 11 times in Model United Nations, in Hamburg, Germany. Unfortunately, the pandemic, at least for now, stopped our participation. Again, that meant preparing both the whole trip logistically and assisting the students, organizing them, both making sure that they arrange all the issues and all the paperwork, and then they are well prepared for the trip and have fun there and manage to arrive back home. I guess I should move on to the other ideas. Briefly, when it comes to, let's say, my expectations from the trip, I honestly love traveling. So any kind of chance to visit places and meet people, that's the brilliant opportunity. What is more, since we've got a number, I will connect with the next one, since we have a number of students applying, both, well, actually any kind of foreign universities, there are always a few applying to American universities. A possible chance to see one, to talk to a few people there, might make it easier for me and my colleagues to help them prepare, or for us to probably to present them better in their letters of recommendations, which we prepare for them. Coming back, I imagine that I can share my experience both with other English teachers as well as the teachers of science or mathematics, who are, the subjects such are the key in at our school. And that's my view and like that.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you very much, Professor. If I may ask Marzena Bielecka for her questions.
Thank you for the introduction. I would want to ask you a question which I think you haven't covered in your presentation. How are you going to spread around the knowledge which you will gather during the visit to Silicon Valley?
I mentioned that as sharing the information with my colleagues. I must admit I'm not too much into social media and sharing information through such sources. To some extent, I can't predict what will happen. Yeah, so I don't know what else I will do. From the point of today.
Okay, and one more question. What are your expectations vis-a-vis the organizers of this scholarship? Do you have any, or maybe none?
No. I believe that I know a little bit how such trips are organized, and I know that the questions occur throughout the process. So for the time being, I feel kind of well informed. But what kind of questions may occur later on, hard to predict.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. Piotr Kamiński.
Mr. Professor, you mentioned that that you have some ideas which you had before you received the information from us. I give you this 3 minutes to share with us these ideas.
Probably that would come down to more or less what I had just presented. The The only difference was that initially the information was that I was to present myself more, but I was happy to share that. So probably I would share more of my love for the books or the written word or the contact with the students. And actually, I will take the opportunity to one point I haven't had a chance to mention, as what I feel with actually kind of popular phrase information overload. And I feel that students today, when compared with those I started working out those nearly 30 years ago, they have very easy access to information throughout the internet and other sources and media. But what they value a lot is the word of mouth and actually the real experience. So not what me or anyone else can tell that they saw on YouTube or somewhere else, but what they experienced, what they saw, and what the word is really like.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. If I may ask you, whom would you like to meet in the Silicon Valley? What would be the best experience that you would like to have?
Well, as for the people, well, from this kind of practical point of view, that would be the person responsible for actually applications and recruitment at universities to have this kind of face-to-face exchange about to understand better the way it is organized.
Okay, we have such people with whom we are going to meet. So that's okay. But if you could tell us more, how you are going to share your experience with other teachers and students? Mm-hmm. Very, very briefly, because we have 1 minute.
Yeah. As through the lessons or, well, that's with students, obviously. I believe that, since it's the second year our school takes part in the program, I could introduce it for sure better instead of just presenting the invitation letter. And this year we had privilege to have those who participated last year to share their experience. But I guess with this, we can encourage even more to go, well, through the initial stage of it. With the colleagues, we do have regular meetings, but and through this, we could share experience. And that's, I believe, it.
Thank you very much, Professor. If I may ask Piotr Kamiński for your feedback.
Mr. Professor, I really appreciate your staying with us and the young people from Staszic were really good prepared to this project, and I congratulate you the view how to expand your knowledge, how to help the young people to reach their goals, and really our project is for this to help young people to find the proper decision for their life. And also to help a little the professors from Polish colleges to they have also additional practical knowledge, and I really appreciate that you do share with us this. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Marzena.
From what I heard, I can see that you have proven experience in organizing different kind of trips, taking care about students, which is very important also in this case, because this trip is going to provide the students with a lot of opportunities, but also because of the size, it's quite challenging to take care about all of them, including some which might have special needs or expectations. So I appreciate, I mean, from your presentation that you have such an experience. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm also impressed by your experience in organizing trips of students, and I appreciate it very much. That you dedicate your time to students. Thank you very much, because this is an excellent example for all teachers in Poland. If I may advise you something, is to take more care of social media, because this is inevitable. We need to be present also there. So once again, thank you very much.
In
about 1 week, we will let you know results. As you know, I hope we can see each other in California. The problem is that there are so many excellent candidates.
Yes.
Which is, from one side, very optimistic that there are so good teachers in Poland. And we are very good examples for everyone. Once again, Professor, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.